Hello, everyone, and welcome. Thank you for coming for all this beautiful woman. I'm just so happy to be surrounded with such a beautiful ladies. And to be honest with you, I'm a little nervous, so but it's okay. It looks like I made a lot of speech, but I just wrote it with a big letter, so so I don't have to use my glasses. That's why. So friends and colleagues, thank you for joining me in this celebration of International Women's Day. It means so much to me that we take this time to recognize the incredible contribution of women throughout the world. I feel so privileged to stand among you, today's Women of Glidewell, in first honoring those who came before us. The universe speaks to us through prior generations in countless ways. We are so thankful for our mothers, grandmothers, and prior generations of women whose vision, hard work, patience, and perseverance pave the way for so much more progress. As hectic and challenging as modern life can be, it is so much easier in many ways because of their dedication and sacrifice. To this day, my mother is my biggest hero. Her wisdom, her strength, her understanding. There is so much I never fully realized until I became a mom. Looking back, I have so much more appreciation for what it took to raise 7 children by herself with so much love and dignity. She was so busy raising 7 children that as their last born child, I did not have a name for several months. I would like to tell you a short but very personal story of me. When I was born, my mom was having a very difficult time in her life. Her husband, my father, decided that there were too many kids in the house, and he didn't want to take responsibility, so he left my mother with all her 7 children to raise by herself. On top of all those difficulties that my mother was going through, her beloved father unexpectedly passed away. A few months later, I was born, she realized that she didn't get me a birth certificate. Not to mention that at that point, I still didn't have a name. It is kind of a big deal when you don't have a name when you're a few months old. So she asked my next door neighbor, who was very beautiful, intelligent young lady, to go and get me a birth certificate. Since we lived in this small village, she had to go to town for birth certificate. When she arrived at the town hall, she realized that she had forgotten to ask my mother what to name me. So she picked up the phone and called my mom and asked, "What would you like to name your daughter?" My mother never thought about it. Of course, she was so busy with all the crazy things was going on. Until that moment, and even though she asked my neighbor to go to get the birth certificate, in our culture, and I'm sure here as well, some people name their kids after certain occasions or movie stars. Like if you were born in a winter month, they would call you Winter, or if you were born during the storm, they would call you Stormy, or something like that. My mom thought about few unfortunate events that happened since my birth. It would make perfect sense if she named me Parto B, especially since my father left us. It was totally made up name. There is no one named like Parto B. There is no such a name. Parto B in Tajiki means left behind, thrown away. My neighbor who was about to write my name on the birth certificate thought that that name definitely didn't suit me because of course I was cute little baby. I was finally named Parvina because of my mom's friend who stepped in to help to get my birth certificate and said I should be named Parvina, not Parto B, like my mom threw out aimlessly because she was exhausted caring for all my siblings. My name, Parvina, is a Muslim feminine name of Persian origin that means shining star. The name, thank you. The name is often given to girls who are seen as being beautiful, intelligent, and talented. I'm so blessed that universe stepped in to help my mom to give me proper name connected to a constellations. And I believe that this name changed my life. Today is the day to honor how the universe guides us through our life. We are all connected and guided by the universe if we open ourselves to the beauty of the constellation and all it has to offer. Today, we celebrate a fifth year of the Women of Glidewell as we have been brought together by the universe to celebrate this special moment together. Let's appreciate how the universe guides us and lifts us up each and every day. Let's continue uplift, empower each other to be the best version of ourselves. Happy International Women's Day. Thank you.
Great, I get to go on after that. I don't have anything nearly as moving to say, but I just want to say thank you to Parvina for putting this event together today and every year that we've had it for the last 5 years. So, you know, I was thinking about it, and so I've been here 17 years. When I started here 17 years ago, Anna Amadori was the only female VP in the organization. So when you look at it, it was like, 1% of our executive management was female. we've come a long way since then. And I was at a women's event last week, and I was saying, you know, it's about women. We sort of have this ideal that once we get into that position and that next level of position up in the ladder, that you want to stay there and relish it for a little bit, right? Because it's taken us so long to get there. And yet we forget the other ladies who are behind us who also need that person to help us rise up and see our potential. And I think that's one thing that I've been trying to do, is trying to elevate the women in this organization. But there's so, so, so much more that we can do and that I can do personally. And that is a mission of mine. And I think it's important that we all recognize the power that we hold. Right? Some of us are very quiet. I'm not one of those. The guys that share the office with me know that. I'm not one of the quiet ones, but those that are quiet are the ones that we really need to look out for too, right? Those are the ones who might need a little bit more help from us. And I think it's important that we wrap our arms around one another and find ways to elevate each other. I was looking at these pictures of us up here, and I'm like, wow, I wish I looked like that every day, but I do not wake up like that. That is a lot of airbrushing, right? But when I was looking at it, I was thinking, like, you look at pictures of celebrities or influencers or things on social media, and you think, like, oh, they have so much, or they have all the things that I want. And the reality of it is, we don't wake up like that, right? We come to work, we work really, really hard to get to where we are today. But we all need that person by our side that will help elevate us. So I want to remind everybody, there's not one spot for everyone, right? There might be one CEO in an organization or one, you know, VP of logistics, but it doesn't mean that that CEO or that VP of logistics isn't going to retire one day. And then there's a new VP and then there's a new CEO and there's a new head of something, right? So just always remember there's new opportunities. And then in top of that, when I got here 17 years ago, we were at 1,100 employees. 1,100 employees. Today we're 5,500 employees. We were $110 million in revenue. We're going to be over $700 million in revenue this year. And with that growth, we've created new departments, new divisions, new positions for people. So just remember, growth doesn't ever stop. Not in Glidewell. Maybe in other companies, but not here. And so there's always something out there for everyone. So I just want you to remember that. I want to thank everybody. I know you're all busy for coming out here today and spending the time with us. But again, I really want to take a moment to thank Parvina and Joelle and Crystal and the entire team who put this together for us today. It's such a beautiful event. So let me just give a... So we've changed it up a little bit. We have a few new speakers that we're going to have come share some of their stories with us today. And the first person that we're going to have up is Annie Lee. I've known Annie for a long time. She's been here 11 years. Can you believe it? I think she was like 12 when she started here. But it's been sheer joy to watch her career grow. And now she runs all of the client success division for .io. And it's an amazing testament to what she's been able to do in her relatively short tenure here. So, Annie.
Hello. My name is Annie Lee, and I'm the manager for the client success team for the IO department, campus, and sister labs. As I stand before you today, I am humbled and honored by the opportunity to address such a distinguished audience. It is a privilege to share my thoughts on a topic as important as women empowerment. In my journey here at Glidewell, I have seen firsthand the transformative power of women empowerment. I have witnessed the incredible resilience, strength, and determination of women who broke down barriers. To be able to see the first and OG female executive, Anna Maduri, to 300 women in leadership, it is so empowering that each and every one of us can thrive, succeed, and reach our full potential. By embracing women empowerment within my team, I have seen the positive impact it has on their personal and career growth, as we have a responsibility to actively support and uplift one another, to mentor, advocate for, and empower those around us. By sharing our knowledge, skills, and networks, we can create pathways for other women to advance and succeed in their careers, paving the way for future generations of female leaders. On a personal level, women empowerment has instilled me in a sense of confidence and a determination to pursue my goals and aspirations. Through observing the achievements and successes of other empowered women, I have been inspired to push beyond my own limits and strive for excellence in all aspects of my life. Having a supportive network of mentors, colleagues, and friends has encouraged me to embrace my strengths and overcome challenges. These relationships have been invaluable in helping me navigate obstacles and seize opportunities. By advocating for myself and seeking out opportunities to take on leadership roles and projects, I have been able to expand my skill set, broaden my experiences, and advance in my career trajectory. By embracing the principles of women empowerment and actively seeking out ways to support and uplift other women, I have been able to achieve greater levels of success and fulfillment in both my personal and professional life. Moreover, being part of a workplace and community that values and promotes women empowerment has been instrumental in my professional development, and I am forever having profound gratitude to Glidewell. Together, we have the power to drive meaningful change within our organization and beyond. Let us continue to support and empower one another as we work towards a more equitable and inclusive future for all. Thank you. I'd love to introduce to our next speaker. Oh,
from Parvina and Stephanie.
Oh, thank you. I'd love to introduce to our next speaker, Araceli Martinez.
Hello,
And I'm going to address the fact that I'm a little nervous and startled, but I'm very, very honored to be here today. So I'm going to start off with this famous quote from my grandmother. El que no se arriesga no gana, meaning those who do not take risks never win. And we go about life with what if. So this was my grandmother's motto, a piece of wisdom she passed down to me at a very young age. And today I'm very honored to share that with all of you. It is, again, a true honor to stand before such incredible women today. And I'm here to share with you the transformative power of courage and determination in the face of fear. Throughout my nearly 14-year journey at Glidewell, I've encountered countless moments of fear and uncertainty, our biggest enemies, right? From navigating a male-dominant industry to transitioning through various roles from the production floor, customer service, and a technical advisor, and now in my current role in the learning and development world. But fear has often tried to hold me back. Yet with each challenging moment of transition, I emerge stronger and more resilient than before. Fear is a universal experience, and it's the nagging voice in our head that whispers doubt, the unseen force that holds us back from seizing new opportunities, and the shadow that sadly dims our light. Fear comes in many forms: fear of failure, fear of rejection, and my ultimate favorite, fear of the unknown. But here's the truth. Fear only has the power that we give it. When we embrace courage and determination, fear begins to fade away and loses its power. It's not about eliminating fear entirely, but it's learning how to dance with it and move forward despite its presence. So I'm going to share a little story about this past Tuesday when Joel asked me to speak at today's event. The fear whispered doubts in my ear saying no. I immediately shut down my laptop and I'm like, wait, is this the right person that she's trying to get a hold of? Did they get me confused, right? And my immediate reaction was to automatically say no. And I'm glad I didn't. So I want to share a quote that I recently read from the book Presence by Amy Cuddy. She enters without fear, performs without anxiety, and leaves without regret. And I am really, really glad that I did not listen to those whispers of no. Although it's challenging, I'm petrified, I'm nervous, I have all these mixed emotions, but I'm very excited to represent all you women of Glidewell. So what I want to challenge you today is for each of you to listen to your heart, embrace your fear as an opportunity for growth, and keep moving forward. Don't let fear hold you back from pursuing your dreams or speaking your truth. Instead, let us be defined by our courage, resilience, and unwavering determination to succeed. So let's embrace fear as an opportunity for growth, to take risks, and keep moving forward. Remember, el que no se arriesga, no gana. So those who do not take risks never win. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you all for joining this celebration of International Women's Day. To start, I would like to thank Parvina, who advocates for establishing Women's Day for Glidewell. And I am extremely glad and happy to be given the opportunity to speak a few words about this wonderful day. My journey at Glidewell started actually back in September of 1998. It was in the shipping department. Anna hired me at that time, and it was at a Newport Beach location. It is 25 years now. I was in my mid-20s, just recently came to the U.S., and English is not my first language. I was so thankful that Glidewell offered me the job opportunity at that time, and it was actually my first full-time job in the U.S. So I knew at that time that I would have a lot to learn. And starting as data entry in shipping, I quickly realized that the work in shipping is much more complex than what it looked like, what it may look like. This is because there are multiple multiple sections that shipping is responsible for. Everything starts in shipping and everything finalized in shipping. The starting point would be all our inbound processing that actually cover multiple steps from getting the case data captured to order creation and getting cases ready for production to when the case is ready to ship. We all are responsible to make sure that our billing is accurate and get the case package and hand it to the carrier in a timely manner so the cases can get shipped on time. Everything was so interesting and I wanted to learn everything that I can. And there's a lot to discover. And I still continue to learn today. I think I was extremely lucky. I am lucky still today to be surrounding by great female coworkers who are extremely supportive and willing to give you a hand when you actually need help. And we need that. We need help to be able to do what we do. I put a lot of dedication into my work, and I am lucky and fortunate that Glidewell leadership recognizes my work and allow me to continue to grow. One of the memories that our shipping team probably share that is one of the remarkable transformation that the team is extremely proud of is basically the implementation of the conveyor belt back in 2017. Thing it's completely different before, and since then, it's a huge change, huge improvement in terms of how we process thing in shipping. So it's a big time, big change. I must say that during the 25 years, there's a lot of good thing and not everything is easy. Not every day is easy. There's always challenges that we all face at work. I just want to share where when things get difficult, remember that we are not alone. You are not alone. Stay positive. Stay strong. Do not give up, and we can do it. And women are wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you to all speakers. That was amazing. And let's get another round of applause for them. Thank you so much. Thank you. A lot of inspirational stories. You know, since we started this Women of Glidewell, we wanted to recognize, and I was given very difficult task to choose 10 best nominees that best that we can recognize the Glidewell woman. And it was very difficult to choose those 10 people because as I can look around the room, I see so many incredible women here that deserve recognition and all the good things. But unfortunately, we have only 10 recognized this year, but we would like to recognize throughout the years to come. So with that, I would like to introduce some of our honorees. One of the most accountable, reliable, and fantastic leader in her department, always has a smile, the most calming temperament, and is amazing at delivering results. Tight deadlines and hurdles do not faze her. She is always positive, regardless of circumstances. She manages a development team in both United States and India. Regardless of the 12-hour time difference, her employees are one of the top performers and are very happy to be part of our company. Miss Tinti Praksansan. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. I forgot to mention that when I was choosing how to recognize, and I put Parvina's preference things on those bags. So whatever you have, it's Parvina using every day. So. This lady is a senior Glidewell employee of 25 years. Every crown made in R&D goes through her for polishing, provides flawless input on R&D formulation using her years of experience as a dental technician, lovely grandmother, and pleasing and pleasure to work with, Miss Jackie Park.
Congratulations. Oh my God, thank you so much.
You deserve it.
Oh my God, thank you.
Thank you
very much.
She is an outstanding team member who always has a smile on her face and a can-do attitude. Our customers love her and cannot say enough about her and her vision for creating a stellar Glidewell customer experience. She is also an amazing mother to a beautiful little girl, Miss Victoria Mayers. She first joined Glidewell in 2005. She has worked in the preventative care and removable call center. She even spent a couple of years as a video production assistant in our marketing department. She has amazingly positive attitude and helps build the morale of any department she is in. She is always ready to help anyone and is such a team player. We are lucky to have her in our team, Miss Janelle Dong. Congratulations. This lady embodies the essence of what it meant to be a leader, one who leads not with grand gesture, but with quiet determination and genuine care for those around her. Her ability to engage with employees at all levels of the organization is a testament to her approachability and genuine interest in fostering a support and inclusive workplace environment. She always uplifting those around her with words of encouragement and acts of kindness. She is always willing to lend a helping hand or offer a listening ear, Mrs. Alanda Ramirez. I hope you guys understanding me with my thick accent. So. This lady, she started here at Glidewell right out of high school in 2012 and has risen to manage an important department that is critical to the day-to-day operations of our company. Her learning agility is incredible. She masters the technical information as if she was trained as engineer and has developed an approach that drives operational excellence. She excels independently while fully supporting and advocating for her hardworking team. Miss Anita Elises. She joined Glidewell in 2008 when she was hired as a manager of CAD/CAM in the Zirconia Composite Division. She has always been a driver of technology on the lab floor and is constantly seeking ways to exceed companies' expectations for production. She has seen many department changes and merges in the time she has been here, yet she always continues to be positive influence and role model for her employees. Even in the most challenging of times, you will find her with a smile on her face and positive outlook on life. Miss Trin Dang.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I know it's you. Thank you so much. Digital department.
You want the bag. Parvina's preference. She is known for her positive attitude, consistently providing high quality products to our customers, happy to QC when needed by production. Her personal mission is what we make for the patient mouth needs to be treated as if it goes to our own family mouth. Miss Dang Lam. She probably went to back to work, I think. Woo-hoo!
Congratulations.
She began her journey with as a bright-eyed 18-year-old, and over past 21 years has risen through the ranks to become a senior manager, a testament to her dedication and hard work. Although she is known for her quiet leadership style, she commands immense respect from her team and colleagues, embodying the values of integrity and perseverance. She is the most knowledgeable expert we have in our organization on all things implant removables. Today, we celebrate her not just for her professional achievement, but for her unwavering commitment to excellence and a positive impact she makes on her department, our company, and our customers. Miss Catalina Bowman.
Unfortunately, Catalina isn't here today, so we'll give this to, if Darius is in here, we'll have him take it to her tomorrow.
That would be great. Thank you. The next honoree is an exemplary young woman. Her work ethic is unmatched, and her professionality is a ray of sunshine. She comes to work every single day with a bright smile and willingness to learn. She goes above and beyond with any task or project she is given and is never one to say no, even if the project is something new to her. Her ambition, hustle is obvious not only to management, but also to her peers. She is not only an inspiration to new team member, but also demonstration of how far your thirst for knowledge will get you. She is the type of superstar every team wants to have. Miss Crystal Eisen.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You want to say something?
No.
I'm sorry. Oh my goodness. This lady started with Glidewell back in 1997, just over 27 years ago. She is not one to crave the limelight, but is known for being the biggest supporter for her fellow coworkers while embracing, encouraging others to follow the Glidewell principle. Today, she oversees 8 departments and over 300 employees. Despite the daily unpredicted high hurdles, she remains calm and collective as she guides her team to success. Proud mother of 2 college graduates, she provides successful empowerment path for her children and employees alike. Lover of Del Taco, Mrs. Christine DeLuca. So since we said we have only 10 honorees, but we have one left here, and this one is a Golden Award. And Golden Award, of course, went to the, I guess, most voted or most wanted. This woman, not one. Most loved, I should say, most loved and appreciated. This woman at Glidewell, this woman at Glidewell as an integral part of a Glidewell success. She begin in, I'm trying to read so I don't give up the like clue, that's why I'm trying, but she begin in shipping as a driver and then transfer her to customer care, where she helped manage and development of our first call center and technical advisor group. She also was responsible for developing Glidewell's customer service training program and expanded the call center by 85%. After leaving customer care, she, already you guys know who is that. After leaving customer care, she embarked on a new challenge at Glidewell and developed created our Glidewell Catering Department. Last year, she provided just under $1 million worth of catering to our internal and external customers. She welcomes challenges and is able to pivot and adapt to ensure that Glidewell keeps growing at its record pace. The woman with the longest tenure at Glidewell, over 43 years, Mrs. Paula Labar.
I guess what I always say, and this is always comes up and stuff, is we all are here for each other, ladies. And not here just for the ladies, for everybody. We're all here to continue our growth. We're all here to rise up and bring those people up behind us and make sure that everybody does our job better than we do our job. So we have long-term growth, and we have terrific employees that come down the road and come up behind us. And it's just exciting, because I know when I mentioned Araceli was one person who I thought would be fabulous, because she does have the growth, and it's lovely to see all these wonderful people who have long careers here. And I think that's the best part, is we do have long careers, and we have people who continue to grow within the company. So that's so exciting, and I love everybody. Thank you so much.
Thank you again, everyone. Is anybody want to say a few words? Layla, anybody want to say a few words? That would be, I know I put Layla in a spot, but please, we have an open mic here.
Had to take my gum out first. Hi, everyone. It's an absolute pleasure to be here among all of you amazing ladies of Glidewell. It really does take a village to grow the baby, and I feel like Glidewell's our baby, and takes all of us to grow Glidewell together. I really believe in collaboration, in teamwork, in supporting one another, and I do think that Glidewell really represents all of that, just because, you know, we've been able to grow this company 50 plus years, and I would say, yeah, we have a lot of great men on our team, but I would say that women do tend to work behind the scenes more and more. And now they're more at the forefront of what we do. Women are definitely stronger together. And I'm just so super proud to be here. And I'm grateful for all of you and for everything that you bring every day to Glidewell. So thank you, and keep on going. And of course, thank you, Parvina, for organizing this. I think it's wonderful that we actually have a day in the year where we can recognize one another. Obviously, everybody's included, men and women and everyone in between. So thank you.
Thank you, everyone. And we're going to do this more next year. I hope it's going to be bigger, better for all. And thank you again. No, I got the 80-20.